The Water, Its Origins and Significance 5th Annual Conference of European Association of Taiwan Studies Toddlerhood Institute of East Asian Studies. Charles University The Notion of the Water, 白话文, The Vernacular Literary Language as opposed to the CLAS, Sico Literary Language Finian, 文言, is closely related to the New Literature Movement, XIN-WEX-YUN-DONG-XIN-WEN-XUE-UN-DONG, and the May 4th Movement, WU-XI-YUN-DONG-WU-XI-UN-DONG, 二寸China and the beginning of the 20th century. New literature is defined in terms of the what, and thus there is no wonder that these two terms are usually discussed together. However, the term and phenomena of the what deserve further examination, because it did not only influence the literary style and standard language, 普通话, in China, but also had decisive contribution in discussions on literary language and new literature in Taiwan. The discussion of the one introduced all the fundamental topics that were disputed in further discussions in Taiwan on the new and old literature. XIN-GU-WEN-XU-LUNS-HEN-XIN-JIO-WEN-XUE-LUN-ZHEN on the Taiwanese language, Taiwan Huo-WEN Taiwan Hua-WEN, and then the literature of native soil, XIN-TU-WEN-XU-XIANG-TU-WEN-XUE. The paper aims at setting the Taiwanese Taiwan discussion, 1921-1924, set in the context of Chinese and Japanese literary development. It explores the fundamental topics influential for further developments of Taiwan literature. At the same time, it compares the arguments used in both Taiwan and Chinese discourses, in order to show ideological shifts on the Taiwan side. Behua literature and Behuaman, before examining Taiwanese discussion on the Behuaman, however, it is necessary to define what Behuaman is and how it was perceived at different time periods. Traditionally, the movement for new literature started in 1916. It aimed at introduction of literature written in vernacular that should have replaced the literature written in Finnian. In the same time, it opposed the traditional literary conception that the literature should convey Confucian moral principles, when his ideal 文艺载道. The critique did not target only literature itself, but also had far-reaching consequences in social and political sphere. Among main figures of the movement belong Chen Daxing, Chen Duxiu, and Hu Shi, Hu Shi. Er, the May 4th Movement, 1919, aroused in China as a reaction to unequal international treaties after WWI. It was initiated by students from the Beijing University and soon followed by other students and workers. The May 4th Movement influenced not only political development, but rather cultural sphere and literature. It stimulated the wave of nationalism and re-evaluation of some cultural and social patterns. In the view of the New Goals, literature was understood as a tool of modernization and enlightenment. The May 4th movement used to be designated as the symbolic shed which the new Chinese society and literature derived its existence from. My primary sources are rather limited and depend on the anthology Taiwan New Literature Under Japanese Rule edited by Li Manhun, 1979. 2. In short, the complex view on the topic, further research in archives would be needed. The anthology, however, includes all important texts dealing with the topic. But what is the vernacular, based form of written language? It was originally limited to certain genres of popular literature, mainly the medieval stories recorded by the storytellers. Norman 1997, 137. The distinctive quality of the Benhua language is that it resembles the contemporary spoken language, but as it has been a written language, stylistic, lexical and grammar change shape occurred, and Benhua has often received various influences from the other literary language, Fengyan, Wenyan. 2007, 222. The early origin of Benhua could be traced back to the end of Han, when the structure of Fengyan was settled and did not follow the changes of the spoken language anymore. The development of Benhua could be divided into 3 different stages separated by 2 border periods, Sui and Tang dynasties and the May 4th movement, when defining both written languages, Benhua and Fengyan, we have to take them as complementary. Firstly, even though both of them are literary languages, each of them uses different vocabulary, grammar and stylistic devices. 2007, 184, 185. Secondly, they are also linked with different social groups. But as Shen reminds, the boundary between the two often blurs, because there are many cases when both styles mingle into one another. The third difference is in the adaptability of the language. Since Wangyan did not follow changes in the spoken language, it could overcome differences of spoken languages in different regions or social groups. But Benhua might have been influenced by the local dialects. 2007, 187. The reasons for introduction of Benhua in both China and Taiwan could be traced back to the 19th century, when the request for simple literary style free of ornamentation first appeared. The first advocates of such style raised their requests in Japan in the 1870s. 四 The first stage that ended by the period of the Ten Sui dynasties is defined as formative period and the Wa is perceived within the figure. The second stage that took place during the Ming and Qing dynasties, the Wa became a separate language. In this period the first literary writings in the Wa that become a canonic writings in the Wa and the part of higher literature. The third stage is defined after the May 4th movement when the Wa was considered to be the only legitimate literary language. All three stages of the Bewa can also be defined in terms of lexis, grammar and employment in literary writings. 2007-1901 While opinion was used by higher educated elites and it conveyed official literature and writings. The Wa, on the other hand, was the language of markets and the literature, which was written in the Wa, was perceived as lower. 2007-186 As examples may serve poems appearing in the popular literature, and colloquialisms appearing in some official writings. Then the Wa was used to record philosophical debates or talks and it was popular during Ming and Qing periods among the literati. 2007-186 Give songs of state to Chu-sai-shu-tsu as an example. But the first voices, who studied the foreign languages, already called for simplification of the written Japanese in the second half of the 18th century. These were the predecessors of the later advocates of simple literary style and of script movements in Japan. Romanization movement and Kanon movement. For more information see Y1983. Then was Fukuzawa Yukichi, Fuzhe Yuji, who in 1873 took his teaching on writing, Moji no Ocean 文字之教, suggested reducing the number of Chinese characters to simplify the Japanese script while keeping its readability. 9 and more decisive argument, in terms of Chinese and later Taiwanese discourse. However, was the conception of unification of the spoken with the written language, Yan Wei Yuzi, Zhen Ben Yiche Yan Wen Yizhi, that appeared at the beginning of the 1880s. The new literary language, which was the outcome of the conception, became the most outstanding cultural phenomenon in the Meiji Japan. It had to be a relatively simple and understandable linguistic medium, and at the same time it should have the literary value to compete with traditional styles. The new literary language also had a non-literary function, to serve as a tool for the acquisition of knowledge and to mediate spurring nationalistic sentiments caused by the encounter with Western culture. Thomas 1999, 333. 赢了1870 S and 1880 S. There was a vigorous debate on the conception of the new literary language, and there first appeared documents lately used in China and Taiwan. She asked for China, the first advocate of simple written language was Huang Zunxian, Huang Zunxian, who already in records from Japan, Riven Kyoshi Ribbon Guoji, published in 1887, propagated the idea of unification of spoken and written languages, Yan Wen He Yi Yan Wen He Yi, that would create a new style closer to spoken language. However, he demanded this style within the opinion. Yan 1996-20, he and other reformists from Wei Wu Pai, became the predecessors of the new literature revolution. The term Beiwan was introduced together with the new literature movement and the May 4th movement. Hu Xi, who was the ideological father of the literary revolution, introduced the term as the language of the new literature, which was based on the spoken language Shi Yi Hu Xi for the first time put Beiwan and Binyan into sharp opposition and assigned to both of them new significance. Beiwan and its literature was said to be living, while Binyan, Yuwen Guwen, as Hu Xi called it, and the traditional literature was dead. 9. For further reading regarding script reforms, the Kanon movement and the Romanized script movement, in Japan CY 1983-10, they refer to the European national states language policy that employed vernacular language to become official. They pointed out that the new language is egalitarian one. The traditional written styles are rather elitist. As for the literary functions, it was believed that only plain, straightforward language could describe the subtleties of human life without exaggeration or ornament. Among the advocates of the new literary language belonged Sabaoqi Shy, Ping Nei Xiao Yao, who in his Essence of the Novel, Shisetsu Shins Wei Xiaoshuo Shen Sui, emphasized imperative of description of reality without the subjective intrusion of the writer and decisively influenced further understanding of the literary language in terms of realistic description and inner authenticity. Thomas 1999-340-341 11. For the plans of the new literature movement, see Hu Xi 1917b. Some modest proposals for the reform of literature and Chen Doc Si Lu 1917 on literary revolution. Hu Xi, when advocating the new literary traditions, used two decisive arguments. The first one was the reconstruction of the history of the Beiwan literature that reached the period of the first translations of Buddhist scriptures. It included not only the text of lesser importance, but also religious, philosophical texts, and some pieces belonging to the canons of high literature. Thus he created an alternative canon, and a long tradition of Fenhua literature 12 that could compete and even be superior to the literature in Fenyan 13. By doing so, he gave the Fenhua language a symbolic meaning that supported reformists' fight at the social and political level. The second argument, the historic determination of Fenhua's role in modern society, was derived from the Darwin theory of evolution and was, in his opinion, inevitable. His arguments, symptomatically, thus combined both tradition and new Western ideas. However, this still does not answer the question what Fenhua is. It is obvious that even in the terminology, there is the opposition between the speech, huahua, and writing, xiexian, text, wenwen. Even though the Chinese reformists denounced the classical literary language, it did not mean they immediately used the codified written language based on spoken language. And the script, used in this transitional period after the May 4th movement, is called Fenhua. As written above, it's stood in opposition to Fenyan and its only precondition was to have it must be the language that people speak and understand. Its standards were vaguely set by the canon of the great Ming and Qing novels introduced by Hu Xi. Hu 1948, only in the late 1920s and the 1930s Hu Xi retrospectively gave definition of Fenhua and Fenhua literature. I enlarged the scope of the literature in Fenhua, and it includes writings of old literature that, in terms of understanding, approach speech. I always say that Fenhua has three meanings. Firstly, it is derived from reciting on the stage. It simply means the speech that can be expressed and understood. Secondly, it resembles the meaning of the word pure and refers to speech that is devoid of ornaments. Thirdly, its meaning comes from the word understand, so it is a speech that is understandable and smooth. Hu 1928, this adds to the traditional understanding of the term. To tell a story, the first meaning quoted above, a new significance, combines different meanings and blurs the boundaries of both literary languages and literature itself. This understanding of the terminology is decisive not only for later definitions, but also for Taiwan as perception of the conception, which will 12 for the canon see Hu Xi 1928, the history of literature in Fenhua. Part I 13, it should be added that his perception of what belonged and what did not to the Fenhua literature tradition was not systematic, and the discrepancies aroused mainly from the reason that the border between Fenhua and Wenyan was not clearly defined by Hu Xi. Many of the literary writings that were included in his canon were not written in contemporary Vanuatu, but were only influenced by the vernacular to some degree. For further criticism, see Josie Uren, 1936-4. Be discussed later. In 1940, Hu Xu gave another specification of the woman, which is also interesting in terms of Taiwan, as debate on the literary language, as he took Fu Xinyan as two arguments as a starting point. 14M emphasized that local dialects and European influence, which had lately penetrated in the Guanghua, the Mandarin Chinese, had proved the diversity and vitality of the what? The argument is again supported with the examples from the canon of Benhua literature to show that Benhua always accepted influences from local dialects. 15-38. On the other hand, it must be stressed that Taiwanese intellectuals did not come into touch with these concrete definitions and knew only the vague specification given by the canon of Benhua literature. 16 Benhua and literature in Benhua had an ultimate goal, i.e. to convey new ideas and realities that appeared in the new changing society. 1940-13, Finian could not achieve such a goal, because new social order, new ideas, aesthetics and so on required a new language that could convey them. 17 At the same time, both the one and its literature should serve as a tool to propagate these ideas among the people, to educate them and to make them aware of the social and political reality. Social mobility, which was an aim of these reformists' efforts, is one of the most important criteria in the process of forming national identity, because it aims at making a homogeneous society that would perceive itself as a political unit. The modern state Shibab is rather long definition of Benhua and Benhua literature in China, their history, and relation to other languages, Finnian, Guanghua, dialects, etc., are essential for understanding the Benhuan conception in Taiwan. Benhuan in Taiwan, when trying to fulfill the requirements of the conception of Zhen Fengqi, the Taiwanese had several options how to achieve it. Benhuan, which was one of the, for several reasons. 14 Fu Xinyan argues that Benhuan must follow spoken language, so it includes only what can be said. Secondly, Benhuan should show the influence of Western languages, because it conveys the new, sophisticated Western ideas. It must be pointed out that the early writing, Benhuan admired by Fu Xinyan and Hu Xu, was later criticized for its difficult style, including a variety of local dialects and foreign phraseology. Finally, it was entitled as New Finnian, X I N Finnian Xinwen Yan. 出1932 15 Husha 1940 38 Gives following examples Hong Kongman, Hong Lou Meng, as the Beiwan. Influenced by Beijing dialect, ruling Wei Shi, ruling Wei Shi, and Lao Kun Yuji, Lao Can Yu Ji, are examples Wang Hu from the central China, has had what? Lui Aswen, Hai Shang Hua Lie Zhuan, is narrating the story using Guang Hu with Su's Lao dialect. 16 Klingman, 2003, and Yashitao, 2000, both report that Taiwanese intellectuals gradually lost contact with mainland China during the 1920s and lately were not aware of China's development. 17 For example, say, Chopin, 1918, argued that the Western conceptions and literary writings should be reading original, because the Vinyan could not convey it. He called for a new language that would create new vocabulary, which would fit to the new realities. 18 For these processes and criteria, see Gelder. 1997. Surpassed the others. Huang Keoki, 1923, in Taiwan and Husha, 1940, showed that in the Chinese context there were several other attempts to unify speech and written language. This, however, unlike Beiwan, did not gain sufficient support. 24年2月5日, 19 needless to say that the early articles, 20 which propagated employing Beiwan in Taiwan, clearly stemmed from the Chinese discourse. They either openly refer to Hu Xi and his perception of Beiwan as role in modernizing society, or simply took over the main arguments and used it in the Taiwanese context. However, it does mean they were not aware of the recent development in Japan, and when finding the arguments to support Beiwan, the results of Japanese movement in Japan were good example to mention. E.g. Wang Keoki 1923-29. Functions of Beiwan old texts advocating Beiwan in Taiwan shared similar reasons for employing it as written language. They aimed at modernization of society and progress. 21 So Taiwan could be a legitimate member of the global community and contribute to human heritage. Similarly to their predecessors in Japan and China, they denounced the classical Chinese as the reason for the society's backwardness. Taiwanese reformists came to the conclusion that only language close to people could spread new ideas and propagate enlightenment among the population. 22 Facing constantly rising pressure from Japanese colonial government and their language policy, Wang Keoki, 1923, 32年3月3, suggested using Beiwan to educate at least the older generation, which would be much efficient than using Japanese 23, judging from its frequent appearance. The modernization society argument was, in comparison to other arguments, the most relevant and sensitive one. Secondly, employing Taiwan has to be perceived as a reaction to Japanese occupation and presence in Taiwan. The early advocates of Taiwan 24 saw it as a way to preserve Chinese cultural identity and continuation of relationships with mainland China. 19. In the Taiwanese context, it is worth to mention, for example, the romanized script introduced by C.A.I. Pai Huo, Cai Pei Huo, which appeared already in 1922. 20. The Taiwan discussion took place from 1921-1924. Then it became the part of discussion of the new and old literature. The early articles, which are crucial for the Taiwan discussion, are Chen Duan Ming, 1921, A Treatise on Promoting of Dali Used Language, Huang Keo Kim, 1923, Discourse on Reforming Chinese, and Wang Chen Kong, 1923, On the New Mission of Popularizing Taiwan. Among the articles directly influenced by Chinese achievements of literary revolution also belong those of Shen Wenzhang, 1924a, 1924b, 1924c, 1925-21, Huang Chen Kong, 1923-79. Huang Keo Kim, 1923-23-29, Zhi On Russia, 1923-49, X I Zhou, 1924-67, and others. 22. E.G. Chen Duan Ming, 1921-5, Huang Chen Kong, 1923-14, Huang Keo Kim, 1923-21年2月2日. 23. Similar opinion had X I Zhou, 1924-67, 24. Besides the articles enumerated in the note 18, there can be included article by C. A. I. Taishen, 1923-38. From 1925, the most aggressive advocate, Shen Wozhang, Zhang Wojun, took the initiative and firmly situated the literature within the larger Chinese literary tradition. Huang Keo Kim, 1923-34, clearly pointed out that if Chinese is abandoned, there, i.e. Chinese people on Taiwan, character, their customs and language will disappear. So if Chinese language is not compulsory in Taiwanese schools, we will apparently vanish. Huang Chen Kong, 1923, then, came with pragmatic arguments. He felt that once the reforms were successful in China, there was no need to find new ways to achieve the same goals. In addition, they could use China as books and periodicals, so the process of inhabitants, education and mass mobilization would be faster, not so regionally limited and smooth. 15. The constant anxiety of Japanese assimilation thus caused Taiwan, as clinging to the culturally closer and influential China. In the same time, it must be mentioned that these efforts show certain degree of sprouting national awareness, which became evident in the late 1920s and the 1930s. One of the internal preconditions of the rise of nationalism is the idea of equality. Equality with foreign powers, i.e. China, Japan and West, and equality among the population, i.e. citizens. The ultimate goal of their efforts to modernize the society so that it becomes a respectable member in the world is closely related with the international equality, and the way to approach it acquisition of knowledge, and education of masses in understandable language is then closely linked with the citizens' equality language. Basis for the one as said before, the intellectuals propagating the one drew inspiration from the conception of Japanese and facing the language reality in Taiwan, they had to choose which language would be the basis to be unified with script. Those influenced by the new literature movement and the May 4th movement naturally took over the conception as it was in China and referred to Chinese Beiwan, i.e. vernacular literary language based on Mandarin Chinese. However, it must be stressed here that at the beginning of the 1920s, standards of Beiwan were not settled in China and the definition stayed rather blurred. And the relationship between Beiwan and local dialects was not clarified as well. Hu Xi's argument on the employment of local dialects had rather literary background. It was linked with stylistic diversity and probably with increasing interest of the Chinese literary scene in local cultures, which were viewed as exotic literature of native soil. Slide on to Wen Xuxiangtuwenxue. 25. Literature of native soil of mainland China distinctively differed to one in Taiwan. It was written by young writers coming from distant regions, who on one hand should have critically depicted the backwardness of Chinese countryside, but in same time showed high degree of nostalgia. These writers were trying to overcome a dichotomy caused by different worlds of countryside and city. For more, see Wang 1992-249-353-315-315. Maybe also for these reasons, besides distinct attitudes to use Mandarin Chinese, there were also uncertain voices advocating using, under special circumstances, the local Taiwan language. 26. Surprisingly, we find such opinion in Huang Chenpeng's 1923 on the new mission of popularizing the one. I think to popularize this script in our society one TB difficult. I would like to advise people who are just Starting with studying, at the beginning you do not need to be so rigid, as complex as the Chinese Beiwan is. It is possible to use our dumb language and thus create a compromise Beiwan. After all, this approach is temporary, and then after gradual study and after reading Chinese books in Beiwan, we can create complex Chinese Beiwan. Only thus we can reach our uttermost ideal and be connected with Chinese culture forever. 16. This was in response to some opinions expressed in articles published at that time, which lamented the fact that Taiwanese language already penetrated in Beiwan in 1924-27. This phenomenon, of course, may be seen as a transitional step toward the later requirement of Beiwan based on Taiwan language. The lack of real conception of Beiwan can be also seen from the usage of terminology to describe different written languages. For example, one term might be used to describe opposites, Huang Chen Kong, 1923, and C.A.I. Tai's Pen, 1923, used the term Hanwen, to designate Fenian. C.I. Zhou, 1923, on the other hand, used the term Pingjid Hanwen, 平易 the Hanwen, and meant Beiwan. Even more confusing are, however, terms designating Chinese and Taiwanese languages. For example, in Huang Chen Kong's article 1923, he uses Chinese Beiwan, Zhong Wodi, Beiwan 中国的白话文, and their own state Beiwan, Taman Dizigodi Beiwan 他们的自国的白话文, to refer to Beiwan in China. He then uses Taiwan Beiwan, Taiwan Di Beiwan 台湾的白话文, innate Beiwan, Giyati Beiwan 固有的白话文, and our speech, Wenmendi. Huan 我们的话, and our ordinary spoken language, Wenmendi Pingchang Di Yongyu Pingchang 的言语, to refer to the Beiwan in Taiwan. These concepts arrive their meaning from a binary opposition of us and them, while having rather vague and unstable meaning within themselves. 26. Here I refer to an indigenous Taiwanese language known as Minnan or Hakla. 27. The problem of local vernacular penetrating to written language in Taiwan is mentioned in the article of Shi Wen Kai, Shi Wen Qi, 1924-52. Another phenomenon is the emergence of Japanese within the Mandarin Chinese Beiwan, which is called New Style, XIN Wenti Xing Wenti. Huang K.O. King, 1923-31. While Huang Chen Kong, 1923, recognized the opposition between mainland and Taiwan Beiwan, for him a more important opposition existed between our Taiwan language vs. Japanese. Teaching us in Japanese is good, but isn't it true that teaching in our Taiwan language would mean Taiwan? 湾我们台湾话, which would convey all sorts of sciences starting from the primary schools using our language, within the 湾我们的话, will faster propagate the culture. 汪泉空1923-17 Even though Wang was well known for his cultural affinity to the mainland and his propagation of Chinese Taiwan as written an educational language for Taiwan, in this quotation he also exhibits a certain ambiguity regarding the language foundation for a particular Taiwan Taiwan. This ambiguity, not only in Wang's articles, might have anticipated the promotion of Taiwanese language as a literary language at the beginning of the 1930s. 28 Besides Mandarin Chinese or Chinese Taiwan, there was a second, and in terms of the Japanese movement, even more appropriate option Taiwanese dialect, the real spoken and relatively spread language in Taiwan. By the end of the 1920s, with the weakening of ties between the mainland and Taiwan intellectual communities, Taiwanese intellectuals, such as Wang Shenhui and Guo Qiuhen, now focused more on the local language, which could convey knowledge and modernize society. 29. Choosing Taiwanese language as a basis for Taiwanese Taiwan, however, bring another problem, i.e. how to write down purely spoken language. The power of the Taiwanese language, defined in terms of Taiwanese Taiwan, lay in the ability to exert influence upon the masses and mobilize them. These arguments worked not only for the modernization of society, but also for both the leftist and later proletarian movement, and for the nationalist goals. Since nationalism often coexists with another ideology, they both took advantage of this Taiwanese language as ability. 28 For the arguments advocating Taiwanese as the literary language and Taiwan native soil movement, see Wang Shenhui, Huang Shihui, 1930, how could we not advocate nativist literature? Wu Renbao, Wu Renbao, No. 9. And Guo Qiuhen, Guo Qiuhen, 1931, Jian Shi Taiwan Hua Wen, Yi Titanium Men Jian She, Taiwan Hua Wen, Yi Ti An. Taiwan Xin Wen, Taiwan. Xin Wen 7.7. 29 Under the danger of rising Japanese colonial influence and losing ties with mainland China, they, in accordance with Genmanichi, preferred vernacular language and literature written in this language that would be understandable and able to convey unique condition of Taiwan, which people can identify with. The stress put on the egalitarianism of the vernacular language led them to denounce Hainan, Mandarin Chinese and Japanese as elitist. Their argumentation, however, came closer to proletarian approach. Fleeman 2003, 153-155. Conclusion. Even though it is evident that the Beiwan conception is derived from China, comparison of Chinese and Taiwanese understanding of Beiwan shows that both discourses display some differences. When examining both Chinese and Taiwanese views on Beiwan from the literary perspective, one evident phenomenon appears. In Chinese, or better say Hu Shi, as understanding, usage of Beiwan is historically closely related to literature and it is defined via literature. Because Beiwan ought to replace Finian in conveying the Chinese tradition, from early beginnings it was demanded that Beiwan should have the literary value. On the contrary, Taiwanese intellectuals, no matter whether in the early 1920s or the 1930s, did not follow purely literary arguments, but rather utilitarian ones. Beiwan is viewed as language of ideological and scientific propagation, the language of education, and the language preserving cultural identity, but till 1924 it was not perceived as a literary language. This understanding, as shown above, was caused by political priorities, and is related to the colonial presence in Taiwan. The second reason, I think, has something to do with the fact that the significant literary production in Taiwan started only by 1925, which drew attention to more literary topics, such as the content of literature rather than the form. The local needs forced the Taiwanese intellectuals to concentrate more on the language itself, which represents the second plane under the scrutiny. The Beiwan discussion in Taiwan established a set of functions of the possible written language, which would fulfill social, ideological, and national goals. And since the ultimate goals of the arguments, i.e. social mobilization, did not change throughout differently oriented discussions during the 1920s and the 1930s, it seems that the new language model set by the Beiwan discussion will serve to propagate Taiwanese language. From this point of view, the discussion on Beiwan is, though very short and soon absorbed by the discussion on new and old literature, relevant for understanding later discussion on Taiwanese language, which generally receives more attention in the academic circles. Bibliography. C.A.I. Taishen, Cai Tieshen, 1923. Su Taiwan Min Bei O Chuang Ken, Zhu Taiwan Min Bao Chuang Han, In L.I. Nan Hun Li Nan Hun, et, 1979. Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wen Xu, Min Zhi Wu, Faxian. Zili I.O. Sunan Zhi Yu Ju Xia Taiwan Xin Wen Xue, Min Ji Wu, Wen Xian Zi Liao Xue Ji. Ming's Chao and Shin Zhe Chu Ban Shu. P. 38-39. Chen Dog Si Un 1917 Wen Xu Zhen Ming 文学革命论 E H U Shi et 1940 Song Wo Xin Wen Xu Daxi Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji 中国新文学大系建设理论集 Shen Hai 上海 Li An Zhi 梁友陈都文明陈端明 ,1921 Rion Wen Ge Ke Wei Le 日用文鼓吹论 In Li Nan Hen Li Nan Hen et 1979 Regisia Taiwan Xin Wen Xiu Ming Zhi Wu Faxian Zili Io Sun Zhi 日剧下台湾新文学名集五文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P36 CI 州磁州1923 Taiwan Minbao Chong Ken CI 台湾民报创刊词 In Li Nan Hen Li Nan Hen et 1979Regisia Taiwan Xin Wen Xiu Ming Zhi Wu Faxian Zili Io Sun Zhi 日剧下台湾新文学名集五文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P36 年3月7 Gelmer Ernest 1997 Nationalism New York University Press H. U. Shen 胡适 1917A Li Shi Di Wen Xu Guang Nian 历史的文学观念论 In H. U. Shi et 1940 Song Wong Xin Wen Xu Daxi Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji 中国新文学大系建设理论集 Shen Hai 上海 Li An Zhi 梁友 H U Shen 胡适 1917B Wen Xu Go Li An Cho Wei I 文学改良厨艺 Xin Jing Nian 新青年 CV2 五音 H U Shen 1940Song Wong Xin Wen Xu Daxi Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji 中国新文学大系建设理论集 Shen Hai 上海 Li An Zhi 梁友 H U Shen 胡适 1928A 四字自序 In H U Shen 胡适 1928本望温修学白话文学史 Shen Wang 上卷 Shen Hai 上海 XINU 十点新月书店 HU 深胡适1928本望温修学白话文学史 Shen Wang 上卷 Shen Hai 上海XINU 十点新月书店 HU 深胡适 1940A Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji Daniel 建设理论及导言 In HU 深胡适 at 1940 Song Wong XIN Wen Xu Daxi Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji 中国新文学大系建设理论集 Shen Hai 上海 Li An Zhi 梁友 HU 深胡适 at 1940 B Song Wong Xin Wen Xu Daxi Jun Shi Lai Lung Ji 中国新文学大系建设理论集 Shen Hai 上海 Li An Zhi 梁友 Huang K.O. King Huang朝廷1923 Han Wen Gage 汉文改革论 In Li 900里南横 at 1979 Regis Ya Taiwan Xin Wang Xun Ming Zhi Wu Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五文献资料选集 Ming's Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 二十年三月六Wang Chen Tong Huang Chen Tong, 1923. Lun Pu Jin Bei Wa Wen DXIN Sheng Ming, Lun Pu Ji Bai Hua Wen De Xin Shi Mi. In Li Nan Hun Li Nan Hun, et. 1979. Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wen Xun Ming Ji Wu.Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五文献资料选集 Ming's Chao and Sh 明泽出版社六二十 Zhi On Russia 建如1923 When Hua Yun Dong Shen Zhi U Sixi On Di Hong Tu 文化运动新旧思想的冲突 In Li 900里南横 at 1979 Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wang Xun Ming Zhi Wu Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五文献资料选集 Ming's Chao and Sh 明泽出版社P 四十七五十一 ，Clayman 费 U N 两千零三 ，Under an Imperial Sub Japanese Colonial Literature of Taiwan and the South, Honolulu University of Hawaii Press， 十一 ，Li Nanhun at 1979。Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wang Xun Ming Zhi Wu Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五文献资料选集 Ming's Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 Norman Jerry 1997 Chinese Cambridge Cambridge University PressQi and Fei Qian Fei, 1924. Taiwan Ming Bei Ozan Mei En Bula Ting Yong Fin Yen Wen Eni, Taiwan Ming Bao Zeng Mo Yang Bu Yong Wen Yen Wen. Ne, In Li Nan Hun Li Nan Hun, et. 1979. Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wen Xun Ming Zhi Wu.Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五文献资料选集 Ming's Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 五十八六十二 Q U 凯五白徐秋白 Sh 凯一二十铁儿一千九百三十二 Pulo Das Hong When My ID Went T.普洛大众文艺的问题 In 周央周阳 at 1987 Zong Wong XIN Wang Xiu Dag C 1927-1937 Wang Xiu Lai Moon G 中国新文学大系 1927-1937 文学理论集 Shanghai 上海 When I Chao and Sh 文艺出版社诗文开诗文起 ,1924 DUIU Taiwan Ren So De Bei Wan De Wo Ji Ang 对于台湾人做的白话文的我见 In Li Nan Hun Li Nan Hun et 1979 Regis Ya Taiwan XIN Wen Xun Ming Zhi Wu Fag Xian Zi Li Io Sun Zhi Yu Zhu Xia Taiwan 新文学名集五 文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 52年5月4 Thomas C. Massimiliano 1999 Quest for a New Written Language Western Rhetoric and the Genfenichi Movement in Monumentalico and ICA Fall 54 No 3P333360 Twine Bennett 1983 Towards Simplicity Script Reform Movements in Meiji Period Monumentalico and ICA Fall 38 No 2P115132十一周西周一千九百二十四 Geology 韩文的普及奖励汉文的普及 In L.I. Manhun 李南恒 at 一千九百七十九 Regisya Taiwan XIN Wenxiu 明之五 Faxian Zili Ao Sun 之日剧下台湾新文学敏集五文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 6768 Yan Ting Yan 严廷亮1996 Wang Qing Sky Show Line 晚清小说理论 Edition Wen Shen Sishi Wen Ke 文史知识文库北京北京 Zinghua Shilian 新华书店 Y.E. 石涛叶石涛两千 Taiwan Wenxiu Shigan 台湾文学史纲高雄高雄上米 Chao and Sh 春晖出版社 Wang David Der Wei 1992Fictional Realism in 20th Century China, Naogang, Lao Shi, Shen Kongwen. New York, Columbia University. C. Shupen Zhang Shoupeng, 1918. Wenxiu Goli and Yu Peng Jiao, 文学改良与孔教。殷殷孙振的欧振振铎 ，at 一千九百三十五。Zong Wong X I N Wenxiu Daxi Wenxiu Lance Han G 中国新文学大系文学论征集。全快上海 Li An G 良友。San Wong 张张我军 Yu Lan 一郎一千九百二十四 a。Chin Heli Chek Sia Sesso Baiko Yan Song Di Po Ju Dai En Ten 请合力拆下这座拜草样中的破旧殿堂 In L.I. Manhun 李南恒 at 1979 Regisya Taiwan XIN Wenxiu Ming Ji Wu Faxia Zili Ao Sun 之日剧下台湾新文学名集五文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 8188 San Wong 张张我军 Yu Lan 一郎1924笔 Zhu Wu Jin Yu Di 摘播音 DVD 绝无仅有的及播音的意义 In L.I. Manhun 李南恒 at 1979 Regisya Taiwan XIN Wenxiu Ming Ji Wu Faxian Zili Ao Sun 之日剧下台湾新文学名集五文献资料选集Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 8992 San Wong 张张我军 Yu Lan 一郎1924 C 西台湾 Qingnian D E Fan X I N 至台湾青年的一封信。In L I Manhun 李南恒 at 1979 Registrar Taiwan X I N Wen Xiu Ming G 五 Faxian Zili I O Sun 之日俱下台湾新闻学名集五文献资料选集。Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 55-57 12 San Wo Zhang Zhang Wo Ju Yulan Yilang 1925 XIN Wen Xiu Yunlong Di Li Li 新文学的运动 In Li Nan Hen 李南恒 at 1979Registrar Taiwan XIN Wen Xiu Ming Zhi Wu Faxian Zili I O Sunan 之日俱下台湾新闻学名集五文献资料选集 Means Chao and Sh 明泽出版社 P 98-103 San Song Sing 张中行2007 Himian He Ben Wang 文言和白话，北京中华社之中华书局，周希仁周作人，1936 ，Wen Xiu Zhen Ming Yun Dong， 文学革命运动 ，In A Yin A Yin At， 中华 X I N Wen Xiu。Daxi Shirley I O Su Yan 中国新闻学大系史料索引。全派上海 Li Anzhi 良友。https://www.solas.ac.uk/taiwanstudies/meets/eats2008/file43158.pdf